What's up, everyone? It's Jonathan from OT for Tech, and today we're going to be taking a look at a case for the iPhone 6 Plus from Power Support. I did a review a little bit ago on the air jacket for the iPhone 6, and I stated how slick it was and how it attracted fingerprints like crazy. Well, Power Support was kind enough to send me the matte variant of this case for the iPhone 6 Plus. You can purchase this case along with the standard smoke and rubberized black variants on their website or in your local Apple store. Options may be a bit limited in the Apple store, so it might be best to purchase directly from the website. They retail for $29.99, but Black Friday is right around the corner, so you may want to keep an eye out for deals and specials. Inside the box, you get the case itself, which we'll go ahead and set to the side. Behind the insert, you'll find some paperwork, which covers the installation and removal process. Being that this case provides an extremely snug fit in order to maintain the slim profile on the iPhone 6 and 6 Plus, you may want to at least glance at the directions, just to ensure you don't screw up your phone or case. The case is made of hard plastic with a matte finish on the back with somewhat softer plastic sides. The case is not flexible, however, like silicone cases, so it's going to provide a bit more protection than, say, a standard TPU or silicone style case. One thing I really like about this case is that I can fit my 6 Plus in it without any issues or having to take off my skin. As you can see, I have my D brand brushed metal skin on my iPhone 6 Plus, and installing the case on the phone is just as simple. Simply start with the mute toggle switch and volume rocker side, then working yourself around the case, go corner to corner and edge to edge and ensure the case is safely and securely fastened to the phone. It will snap, pop, and click to let you know that it's on correctly. It's a painless installation process, just remember not to force it too much so you don't break the case or damage your phone. I really love how the back of the 6 Plus is still visible even if it is a bit cloudy due to the matte finish. Alright, so let's go ahead and set this thing down and take a look at the sides here. Of course, like other air jacket style cases, it does not have built-in buttons. Instead, it has button cutouts, including the one on the right for the power button. And you can also see the SIM card slot is visible even though it's not accessible. Moving on to the left-hand side, you can see just like the power button, you have cutouts for the mute toggle switch and volume up and down buttons. Even though these are cutouts rather than built-in buttons, they are still very shallow rather than deeply recessed, making them easily accessible. The bottom houses a 3.5mm headphone jack opening, which is combined with the mic cutout. You should not have any issues with third-party headphones. You also have your lightning port cutout, and again, most third-party connectors should be okay, but there are some that will not fit. Next to that, you have your dotted hole pattern cutouts for the speaker. You really don't get any lay on the table protection with this case, especially if you use a screen protector like the one you see here. However, that's not too much of an issue for me since I don't lay my phone face down. Since the case offers a snug fit but still is a bit thicker than some of the other slim snap-on-the-back style cases, you're gonna get some camera protection, meaning that it will fix the annoying protruding camera issue that the iPhone 6 and 6 Plus is known for. I love the frosted matte finish on the back, which exposes the Apple logo. Paired with my skin that I have on my iPhone 6 Plus, I believe it makes my iPhone look like the shit. It offers an excellent grip and in-the-hand feel. Although I must say it does make the phone feel even bigger than what it already is, it's not by much. It still maintains a slim profile compared to other cases on the market. It's relatively the same size as the Apple leather case, but offers a little bit more protection. Overall, the in-the-hand feel is really good. Buttons are easily accessible, including the power, volume up and down, and of course the mute toggle switch. No functionality is lost with the use of this case. Since the case is small, it's not going to give you the best drop protection per se. Waist height on wood floors, maybe even tile, should be fine. On concrete, probably not. Just make sure you have a decent screen protector on your phone if you have butterfingers. So let's go ahead and get into some issues I experienced with this case. Every air jacket I have ever owned always experiences significant wear and tear on the inside of the case. I'm not sure what it's from. I've never noticed any damage from my case to my phone, so you don't need to worry about that. However, you can see slight abrasions on the interior portion of the case. Also, I noticed some slight yellowing on the corners and edges of the air jacket matte variant, which did not happen with the standard version or versions since I've used this case on my Moto X, iPhone 5S, and iPhone 6. Removal of the case is a very simple process. Start by removing the corner closest to the 3.5mm headphone jack. Once you have that pried off, remove the opposing corner closest to the speaker. Once you have the two separated, go ahead and remove the rest of the phone off of the case. It's as easy as pie. Simply take your time and do it correctly and you won't have any issues. Honestly, all bullshit aside, the case is a really good case. I use it day in and day out, especially when I go to the gym and I just need something lightweight on my phone to protect it other than just my skin. My biggest complaint would probably be the price. I just feel that 30 bucks is a bit steep for this particular case. But if you're looking for one and you're interested, the link is in the description below. Make sure you go check them out. Well guys, I hope you liked this video. If you did, don't forget to hit that thumbs up button. It really helps out the channel. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any of my new content. And while you're at it, why don't you check out some of my older videos? You might like what you see. Follow me on all my social media networks to have a more one-on-one based chat with me. And don't forget to leave a comment below and let me know what you thought. Of course, as always guys, thank you for watching and all your support. And I'll see you in the next one.